in his item build. And there it is, the Fiora, yeah. Azale, you called it. So it is not the Irelia. Take that one back.
Like
shame
it.
On me. But another great squishy mobile fighter for KFO. The Gragas will set him up. Yeah, something we used to talk about way back in the... Ooh, hold on. Yeah, KFO got to run back under his turret, but here comes Zardok. They want to die this one, and Lorlo is tanky. KFO taking way too much damage. A great first blood. What a dive from Liquid. You can rotate.
Fortunately, though, Pez is here. Can Kez get here in time to actually affect this at all, though?
No, KFO pops the ulti. He doesn't actually repost the knockup. Flash the way right as Kez comes in, but now it's just switching who's going to get killed, as his Gragas is going to get dived under the turret. Zardok to just withstand the damage output, and Lorlo chomps him with the grasp at the end, dying. A second kill for this.
The Sun Fiora, but TL is collapsing. Here goes Phoenix.
Phoenix in, Hemoplague on a three. Red team has slain the Rift Herald, but it's going to be a kill quickly on a Kez. Can somebody even pick up the sigil in the first place? It will eventually despawn if no one grabs it. KFO stuck on the other side of the wall, and that's going to be a quick chase for Zardok. Another kill picked up, 2-0. And I believe that sigil...
He's going to keep going. Oh, they're behind. They're looking to make a play. We'll see if they can do it. Zardok's coming from behind.
The Phoenix, plenty of damage across there. And here comes the pool and the Hemoplague into the back line. He's going to heal up plenty. Quick stun out of Froggatt's Cassiopeia. Vic has to flash away and just no one's taking any damage anymore. They're chasing in. Finally, Fabi might go down. That's going to be a kill up for KFO. It's a trade back as Big has fallen down. 4v4, but Echo Fox are now surrounding Liquid. Maybe they can get something more.
Yeah,
Phoenix
look at Matt,
low.
Too. Matt
Another
is low.
Kill, though. Zardok picked one up. He's taken down Keith himself. Froggatt re-engages on towards Phoenix, flashes away, Lorlo on the chase. You can see just how durable this Vladimir is. Phoenix does not care. He's got the empowered heal back up. KFO's gonna give him even more health on this one. Tries to get the chase, finally gets the kill. KFO tries to carry the fight, and Kez should be taking down Matt. It's a bloody battle as KFO stays alive against Zardok, but this Fiora is out of mana, taken down by the smite. The trade does come through, but looks
good
like
job here by KFO. Actually, procs the vital on Zardok to get the heal there, gets a speed up, gets him in range of the lunge on Phoenix for the kill. So well played by him. In the meantime, Keith goes down again. Flashless ashes. Easy. Whoa. People coming from behind. He's got to be careful.
Fabi might get smacked up, though, and the arrow hits Matt in the back. But they've got some time to make this one happen. But KFO's not in this fight. It's still a 4v4. Froggen will go down to this one. Zardok in the back lines looking for Keith. Gets a stun, and Vladimir's in as well. This should be a slaughter now for Liquid. Make that already 3-4 kills picked up. They got one on the side as well. KFO's just knocking down a side turret, but...
I mean, their eyes got
hit, which was a substantial bit of his damage, but now he's getting access to vitals, and actually looks like that's a better situation for KFO, but he's out of mana. He doesn't have any real lunges left. The flash for Frog and a chase gets a little bit of a slow. It should be enough for KFO. A flash out from Lorlo, the flash to chase, the shutdown comes through, and Liquid have not found anything for this.
Lifesteal there to be able to take it down. Oh my god, Phoenix going in for the all-in on Keith.
Setting up his own dive, a big shield comes out, that should leave him alive. Nope, just kidding. Zardok is there with a massive amount of damage, and he picks off the Echo Fox 80 carry. It's a 4v4 now. Fabi running away. KFO gets exhausted and cannot find the damage. He was left out to dry. Zardok just refuses to care about anything in the world. He takes down
nice
Kez.
Ulti.
A great stun, but who cares? There's no one left alive to help out Frog, and it doesn't even matter.
Step back, make him feel scared, and this should be a free Baron. They see it, sure, but Kez is miles away. I think they're just going to make the call and try to finish, and it should be theirs.
Not even a problem. Blue team has slain.
We'll see if Fox can hold on. It's going to be tough. There's no TP on KFO, and I think they're just going to go for the dive.
They're just going right on in. A pillar on the Frog, and here's a trophy in your back. And Zardok taking some damage. A kill actually comes through. They're picking the people off in this dive, but Phoenix now doing Vladimir things, diving in. Very healthy. Heals him back up. There's a chomp on down. 4 already dropped for Echo Fox. Liquid holding alive with most of their lineup, looking to close the game out right now.
Yeah, I think they can go for the end. We do see that Zardok is going to back, but he can just ultimate right back into the fight. Full HP, KFO basing. Almost no chance to hold on in this 1v4. It's going to have to be a miracle, and I don't think it's going to happen. TL are looking dominant in game number one.
They are once again. Some great early plays. They continued it through the mid game. KFO cannot make it happen. Tried to pick off Lorlo, couldn't do it. 3-5, sadly, his scoreline is the game one victory comes through for Liquid. 27 minutes only. A smashing of a battle.
27 minutes, and the gold lead was almost 15,000. That was a devastating loss for Echo Fox, and it's hard. You know, as the Echo Fox team, what do you change in a game like that? They got thoroughly outplayed in every lane, every matchup. They lost.
But Shen is like the perfect champion for this composition. When Liquid lost against Immortals, it was because Lorlo got smashed in the one-on-one playing Irelia. He had the opportunity to really punish Phoenix. The longer Froggen can freeze this wave, but he pushes it in Rome's bottom instead.
And they're actually looking for a dive here. If you can see in the split screen, Flash.
A trade of flashes. Exhaust on, and that's going to be a kill. That is goodbye. First blood coming through. Nicely done. Thank you, spectators, for watching all three lanes. Let me get that kill down there.
Yeah, we do.
Yep.
That's good things for KFO.
You're talking about a nice flash engage on Keith, who flashes away. The bubble hits Matt in the face, and here comes everyone else. It's Kez, chasing out Dardock. Here's Anivia. Goodbye. The pickup there.
Matt,
a second
down
to on the map, and here is round two. Lorlo ulted to Fabi, not to Matt. So that is a dead Braum, and Lorlo not even really. Or Liquid. They've got KFO on the backside. Here comes the attempt to knock up on the Kez, and Red Team has slain it. Here comes the battle. A double. Bubble
KFO
comes across.
Back.
Matt is low, but look at that. KFO doesn't have a health bar. He's too squishy, and he has to run away. Atan comes out of Lorlo. That's a kill on Nikez. Liquid winning this battle. 1-0 so far. Plenty of damage out of the Ashe, though. Stun and a Dardock. And Echo Fox don't have any turrets really to kill. There's nothing to do for
KFO,
and there's no chance to win that fight when he's built to kill you.
And no chance.
And now KFO.
Dardock,
why are you even here? He's not going to win this fight. 1v2 through a Shen ultimate. A kill for KFO against Dardock. Liquid are falling apart. There's almost no chance of a steal. This should not be missed. Baron goes through to Echo Fox, and Aurelia is still on the bot side of the map. This is a 4v3.
Nice.
They can win. Ooh, a great dodge in the arrow by Fabi, but here comes an attempt at the kills. Matt's going to go down. Phoenix's shield does not bring in enough in time. A taunt by Lorlo stops KFO's teleport, but who even cares? Because look at the damage up at they've got. Fabi's now cut out from his base. Kez going to force the flash,
KFO
but not get knocked.
Nexus turrets.
And he's on Nexus turrets. Yes, he is. Phoenix dangerously almost dead. The Chen. Ooh, oh. KFO can't quite get it picked up, but Keith will. The volley from down.
The GA.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be so hard to even 1v2 this guy.
When the Aurelia finally gets to build tank items, you know life is going to be hard for the rest of the team. A great arrow this time hits Dardock. Matt was not there to absorb it. There's the knockup. There's the damage. There's the kill picked up. Nicely done. Matt's gone as well. Tidal Wave doesn't matter anymore to Fabi. But look at this now. 7-5 as they look to finish off game two against Liquid and bring it to the decider, a team that said, hey, we're right below the top tier, but dropping a game now to the bottom team as they look to kill everybody else off. Matt tries one more time to valiantly hold the door, but it's not going to be enough. A double kill comes through, and this will be the turrets falling, the Nexus to come right afterwards, and 10-1 in kills. KFO split pushing until the very end of it, and Echo Fox cleaning up the rest of Liquid, taking down the Nexus, and getting themselves a game two win over Liquid.
What a game from Echo Fox, and you can see the smiles on their faces. They certainly got a lot to be happy about. That is how the Hecarim, with the Eve, these ways that can kind of, you can just submarine into the team fights and get in there. And I think that because they have such hard engage, KFO doesn't have the chance to go for these kind of dueling split push.
Coming in, Keith has to run, but still gets tagged by Matt's chair. The pass is on him. The ulti to come across, a nice dodge by Keith, but a great top flash out of Lola means that will be a kill picked up. First blood goes over to Fabi, and the only recourse, the fact that KFO gets to shove down to the bot side of the map.
Good. Okay, we'll have to talk about that later.
Yeah, and it's now Matt looking for the kill on to Keith. A quick slow. No, a flash in from Fabi to join in. A layer of crowd control, and Keith will be dropping down. Dardock now to join this fight as well. Big puts down as slow as he can. Puts on the shield. A great
good
stun
cocoon
out of Kez. Yeah, a good cocoon. But now he's got to run far away.
Froggen's
Big will drop to the boomerang. Hits him front and back. Froggen's around. A great seismic shot. The Gnar ulti not quite available. Finally puts it across, and they get themselves at least a kill. But it's 4-1 in total for Liquid now. They've killed many of Echo Fox for only one.
Chase down already has no summoners from the previous exchange. In the bot lane now, though, back to live. Matt is getting taken out.
Kuling actually gets rid of the spell shield, so Fabi's gonna get hit up by the root. The shutdown comes through. The dual lane of Liquid is dead. Froggen,
right back
this time,
even.
Not with Weaver's wall, but still got himself down there.
You know, think that maybe they can get it before they get back here, but Phoenix going on to Kez here. Kez looking like he is going to get taken out.
It's absolutely popped. A nice chase down by the Victory solo kill for as KFO's
away.
In a bad spot without Flash, he should have no way of getting out of this one. Laser dodges don't really matter. Actually manages to force a Flash out of Lorlo, so, you know, making the best of a situation that was doomed to be a death.
But so far up, and actually was not even backing up early. Matt's gonna get cut off here, though. We'll see if they can take him out.
They should be able to. Shenalty coming to back in, and that's gonna be Froggen taunted and killed. The fight that Echo Fox wanted gets completely turned around. Here comes the attempted play once again. Dardock in without the onslaught of shadows, but he runs fast enough. Here's Shen riding in as well, looking for big force to flash where the taunt lands onto Keith, though, and the dive out of Phoenix. That's one. That's going to be two. A great fight for Liquid, picking off even more of Echo Fox.
Can they respond? Some Phoenix with three kills on Victor. That's what you want.
Well, good juke away by Keith, gets himself out of turret range, but Lorlo invincible the damage and just walks away after the attempted taunt. Here's the chase in for Dardock. Big is going to be dying on this one. He's got nowhere to go. A rampage. Page now for Lorlo's Shen, 10-3 in this one. It's only a 2,000 gold lead. It's not catastrophic, but you're just seeing Echo Fox not find anything to do. A nice chair for Matt means the slow, means the taunt, and another kill now comes in for Fabby, 24 minutes in. Liquid looking maybe.
He's gonna try to cut them off. We'll see what they can get done.
He's gonna make them stick inside the Baron pit, and then gets a little bit of poke down on the map, but he's a pretty durable
Culling
prop.
Coming in.
Culling across, Matt might die. The heal actually goes on the wrong chain, but doesn't go down to the ambient AoE, and there's the smite picked up. Dardock grabs it cleanly. KFO still taking damage, actually, from
He'll be able to chase him down. We'll see if he can make it happen, but the minions are gonna be too much. Has to back off, and Froggen's getting caught. Look at that damage.
Solo
from
kill from Dardock. It's probably gonna happen.
Yep.
There's the Onslaught of Shadows. Goodbye. This one feels much better than Game 2 did. I think his KFO can use to do battle. Culling coming across. Bit of damage out of Froggen, but Dardock wants in, pushing him across. A little bit of damage. Root's going to land. That actually will get a pickup on a Dardock. It'll go through the Shen ulti. So now Lorlo can't really join the team. Phoenix dangerously low, but Keith can't get the kill. He's got to flash away. Even the Elise bounce, not quite going to do enough.
Froggen,
but maybe Echo Fox can get it. A slow one to Fabby. The pickoff from Big. Echo Fox managed to grab two kills. Will they get a third? They're looking for it, but they can't reach the opponent.
Has the bonus move speed, Karma shields, and he has the Rylai's. If he lands one spell, they could get the kills. We'll see if they can do it. Repel comes
get
in.
In front of him, and there's the hit coming across, looking for the kill.
Oh,
no! Phoenix turns it back around, but they do trade back onto Fabby. Now, is there a flank for Phoenix? No, there's not. His Rylai's slow. Now at the bot lane inhibitor turret. Top of him is dead. Damage onto Fabby. He's really low. And yeah, they've locked out half the team, but Lorlo's taking the front side. They zone out Phoenix as well. A nice knockup out of Matt, but here comes a couple of stuns. KFO flashes to get the stun on Matt, but that's not enough because Dardock is here, and he wants KFO. Stun's going to land, but the shield keeps him alive.
Big
ulti comes back in. Doesn't lock in many, but it will be the kill on the KFO. They've actually picked up Keith first. A 1-0, a nice fight for Liquid, turning it around. KFO revives, and he's bopped as well. That's two now for Liquid. 5'3", and the health bars are big enough to keep the play going.
Dardock.
Bit of a chance at wave clear. Lolo stunned up. Dardock still very injured, honestly. Echo Fox have one of their major carries.
The
flash taunt comes in. Froggen dangerous, and he is dead. It's now a 5v2. Liquid looking to close it out. Keith! Oh, sorry, it's Big, but he goes down. Phoenix picks it up. Nicely done. Now only Kez stands between Echo Fox and defeat. It's Liquid looking to win this one right now. 5v1. Now 5v2. Keith has come back up, but they might make the dive happen. KFO arrives and alive as well. They've picked
Matt
up one.
Down.
It's Matt going down. They might be able to save this one, but a turret has dropped. An ulti in, and yes, Dardock gets a kill, but it's only a trade. The Nexus
low.
Now left open. Fabby chased in, but the gravity well picks him up, and it gets all of them, and that's gonna be the win. It's Liquid taking down a hard-fought series. It was tight the whole time through, but that's the Nexus, that's the game, and Liquid hold on to a strong record.
Close game there for Liquid, and I think it's a lot closer of a series than they were hoping for. They do close it out off the back of some big plays, and 5-0-2 is the scoreline there for Lorlo. He was instrumental in not only creating the lead, but in getting those picks that helped to end the game. And you know, Dardock with the 5-minute ulti in the bot lane. Phoenix, as always, huge in the late game on Victor.
Absolutely the case. So Liquid pulling out a hard-fought match win, improving them to 7 wins, which keeps them tied with Cloud9, a team they've already beaten once and will play again over in the 9th week to try to get a better seed for themselves. And they've got to try to stay in that top of the pack because there's basically 7 teams right now looking at playoff standings, and one of those isn't going to make it, of course. Echo Fox, to talk about them, do look somewhat better.